Hi, I'm Tom Libous. I want to welcome you to my program for this week. I have a very special guest with me this week. I have Tom Giblin, who is the past chief of the Hillcrest Fire Department, and he is also now the president of the Broome County Chiefs Association. Is that correct?
That's correct, great. Senator.
We're here to talk about fire prevention, Fire Thanks Prevention for having Week. Me. Pleasure to have you here. This is going to be a pretty exciting show, I think, and I would hope that our viewers pay close attention for a lot of reasons. You and I go back a little bit. We've certainly done some things together in the Hillcrest Department, and I still prominently and proudly display the headgear that was awarded me in my office upstairs. I don't know if you got a chance to see it.
A chance to see it. I was very impressed to see it up there, and took some pictures of it, actually, to send back home.
That's great. We're real proud of that, and certainly proud of the work that you and the many men and women of our fire companies. And we've got 42 fire companies and 12 emergency service companies in Broome County. Just how do they all function?
Most of them all function with the help of volunteers. Mm-hmm. There's only, as you already know, three paid fire departments in Broome County, Binghamton, Endicott, and Johnson City. The rest of the departments are all volunteer. So it takes hours and hours of work and people giving up of their lives to volunteer to help their community.
Obviously, you have to recruit these volunteers, and I know that last year, I believe you had your first recruitment day in Broome County, and I remember attending a number of the various fire stations, and I thought it was pretty successful. And I know there's another one coming up. We're going to talk about it, but talk to me a little bit about the success of last year's recruitment day and why we're going to do another one shortly.
Well, we've actually done these recruitment days. This will be our third year coming up, so time flies. Mm-hmm. But the last 2 years we've had it during the winter months, when people might not have been able to get out as readily. This year we're going to do it on Saturday, April 24th from noon to 3 o'clock in all the volunteer departments around Broome County. The last few years we've been fairly successful in recruiting new members at these recruitment days. We've gotten over 60 to 70 new members over the last 2 years. So,
are you happy with those numbers? Or those
yeah, we're very
numbers?
Happy with those numbers. It's tough to get people to volunteer these days, especially for something as labor-intensive as firefighting.
Now, there's various jobs at the fire company that they can work on, obviously. There's, everyone doesn't have to go in and fight a fire. And, we're putting up on the monitor right now, but why don't you share with us some of the things that individuals can do. Everybody doesn't have to go into a burning building. There are other jobs and responsibilities that can be done if you become a volunteer, right?
That's correct, Senator. You don't need to wear an air pack to be a volunteer firefighter. There's jobs for all ages. Most departments will take people from 16 years of age on up. We are in need of fire police people, drivers to drive the fire trucks and pump operators, support personnel at the scene to help move hose and raise ladders, EMS personnel for both the fire departments and ambulance squads are always in need, people that were just interested in teaching children fire prevention. So there's a lot of jobs other than going into
burning
buildings.
So, Tom, if you had somebody that was broken down like myself, okay, just had surgery, got a bad back, but I want to help. What could I do? Is there something for an old broken down warhorse like me that can get involved?
There's always jobs to be done around the station. It takes a lot of effort to run volunteer fire departments or a business. So we could use business people that have knowledge of spreadsheets and dollars and cents to help us manage our money, even help babysit the children sometimes firefighters show up.
I'm sure my fundraising ability could be put to good use.
Absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely, very good use.
You're looking for fundraisers, people who can raise money.
Yep.
I know that I try to, every time I see a volunteer fire company doing a chicken barbecue, whatever, even if I'm not hungry, I'll stop and get one because you can eat it later.
Exactly.
And I know we've been involved in raffles and in different places. And, of course, in the summertime, I spend a lot of time in deposits. So I work with the guys there and try to help them out. So
excellent.
So you don't have to be a big, strong man or woman that's going to go into a fire. You could just be someone who wants to be helpful and become part of that fire company.
Exactly. And there's a lot of camaraderie that comes from being a member of a volunteer fire department. I've been a member in Hillcrest for 21 years. Wow. And I'm proud of that. And I've met a lot of nice people over the years.
Now, is this something that ran in the family? Did you just, what made you get involved?
I actually had a friend that convinced me to join, and he's no longer involved in the fire service. But it just got into my blood, and I've
Good
been doing
you.
It ever since.
Good for you. So. Now, you mentioned earlier that we have three paid fire companies, Binghamton, Johnson, and Endicott. But the majority of companies around us are volunteer, and including the emergency medical services. And please, if I say something wrong,
correct me. You're fine.
I don't profess to be an expert. So it is important that job experience, we can train people, right?
Correct. The training comes to the folks that volunteer free of charge. We provide you with equipment. Whatever you need to become or be a firefighter, whether it's jackets or turnout gear or SCBAs. There's also a lot of benefits to joining. We have scholarships available for younger members that join that want to continue their education. There's a $200 tax credit that was enacted by your group.
We did that. We did that a couple years ago
to try to
get people interested. And of course, why join? A job experience, a free training, a tax incentive, scholarship. We on the state side try to do as many things as we can to get men and women involved in fire companies. And while I know it hasn't been perfect, and certainly with cutbacks, it gets more and more difficult. But these are the reasons, and people want to get involved with the fire company.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's good to give back to your neighbors.
It is a good feeling, isn't it?
It is.
And certainly, I'm sure you've been in situations where you've probably saved many lives, and you know, that's a pretty gratifying thing to be able to do.
It certainly is.
Training is important.
Yes.
And I know we have some photos coming up that we want to just kind of flip through and ask you to comment a little bit about training.
Sure.
Training is very important, because without the proper training, there could be some real issues. And this is
Correct.
A class.
This is a class that was held in Endwell, Firefighter 1 class, which is a basic firefighting class. For new members that join the fire service, they learn all about what it takes to be a firefighter, from putting on your gear properly to wearing your SCBA, to how to properly operate the pumps on the fire trucks, just to become familiar with all the gear and equipment that's involved. It's a very labor-intensive job if you become an interior firefighter, and you need to become very proficient at the tools that you use in the trade.
A lot of work here, isn't there?
There is a lot of work.
A lot of work. I know I've gone to a couple training sessions over the years to really get a handle and feel for the work that you folks have to go through, because if we're going to pass legislation to assist you, we need to understand what that legislation is.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, I'm a pretty lucky guy. I have a couple of young guys who work for me that are actually students that are part of various fire companies, and this is, I think, a picture of Nick Rotella, who is a firefighter in Vestal, and Dave is an emergency medical technician at Harper's Ferry Fire Company. So it's nice to have, as I bring on, young college kids who are working to help us and learn in government.
Sure.
They've already been dedicating their life and doing community service.
Right.
It makes you feel real good.
It certainly does.
It's a good thing.
We try to look at the volunteer fire service as it's a great place to gain experience and learn community service and people skills and management skills. And it's a stepping stone, really. If you want to work for Senator Libous someday, you can.
There you go.
great place to start.
Maybe we'll put that on the on the webpage when we're recruiting.
Sure.
I want to talk a little bit about, we're going to get back to talk about the recruitment day, because we want people to pay attention and to come to the recruitment day. We're going to talk about where it's going to be. But we passed the Manda's Law dealing with carbon monoxide detectors. The law was signed in August, and basically every home built before 2008 needs to have one of these. Why is that important? Why is carbon monoxide and having a detector important in the home?
Well, carbon monoxide is a very deadly gas. It's colorless. It's odorless. You really don't know its effects until it's too late. So I'm glad that this legislation was passed. it became effective February 22nd, I believe, of this year, that every residence has a active and working carbon monoxide detector, especially in homes built prior to 2008.
Look at the statistics that are on the screen there. 500 people die and 15,000 go to the emergency room due to carbon monoxide poisoning. And that's because you can't smell it, correct?
Correct. It's colorless. It's odorless. It sneaks up on you. Really, the symptoms of carbon monoxide poisoning are flu-like symptoms. So flu is prevalent during the winter months, so people might think they just have a flu bug or something, when in essence it could be carbon monoxide.
And the worst month for carbon monoxide poisoning is January, and the period from November to February account for 40% of all the calls.
Right. I mean, in the Northeast, where we are getting tons of snow and the cold, everything's closed up in the wintertime. So if you have a malfunctioning gas appliance, then that carbon monoxide is going to build up. So it makes sense that that occurs during those months.
And I assume that probably folks over 65 or senior citizens are a group that we have to be very cautious.
They are.
Because many times they're alone.
Right.
They can no longer fix up their homes. Or
right.
They don't have the wherewithal to call someone in to check.
Now, correct.
Do fire companies do that? Will they?
They will come out. We go on carbon monoxide calls all the time. If you have questions as to whether your carbon monoxide detector is working, certainly your local fire department will come out and take a look at it for you. We want people to be safe. We don't want to have another Amanda situation occur.
No, not at all, not at all. We've got a couple minutes left, and I really want to talk about recruitment day, and that's going to be April 24th, right?
April 24th from noon to 3 in Broome County.
All
the local volunteer fire departments will be staffed. We'll have applications, an open house, show people the rigs, show people what we're all about, and urge people to join the different volunteer departments around the county.
There'll be presentations that day?
There'll be presentations there. A lot of them will have food and drinks. All the members will be present.
So again, you don't have to run into a burning building. As we use myself as an example, I've got a bad back.
Right.
I recently had surgery, but I could still be an asset
to
the fire company, working in the station, helping with events, raising money, doing other things.
Correct. Yeah, there's always a need for people other than interior firefighters, business people to help organize and run the finance side of things, people just to run the stations, to help out with keeping equipment clean. You name it, there's all sorts of jobs to be done at your local fire station.
So if you want to help your community, you want to become a volunteer firefighter, Broome County is having a firefighter recruitment day on April 24th. That's a month away, but it's April 24th. We want you to know about it now.
Correct.
Between 12 and 3 p.m. at any fire station?
Any fire station in Broome County, any volunteer fire station in Broome County, you can stop in. Most of you have them in your neighborhood. Stop by if you've never seen it. We'd be happy to take your kids through and show them the trucks, give them coloring books or whatnot, soft drink.
I get excited with some of the trucks. You've got some beautiful equipment. It's really a tribute to the men and women of the fire company, where I know you have a tough time with money and you go out
right.
and raise money, but you know your equipment is great
right.
and it really helps save lives.
We're very proud of what we've been able to accomplish with limited funds over the years. We just added on to our local station, so we're
good.
Very proud of it.
Well, Tom, this program kind of went by quick.
It did.
We're down to
very
the last
quick.
30 seconds here. What I want to do is continue to chat with you after the program and do what we can do to help promote the fire companies and certainly recruitment day on April 24th.
Well, we appreciate it, Senator. You've always been a big supporter of us. And
happy to
I'm
do
sure
it.
That it'll continue.
Great.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
I'm Senator Tom Libous, and I want to say thank you for joining this week's program.